a servant of Jesus Christ, and brother of James the Lesser. I'm also known as Thaddeus, or even Judas. I was indeed one of the chosen 12, but not Judas the betrayer. For myself, I was still troubled over Jesus' words at supper and the answers to my question. Judas the money keeper soon took his leave before the meal had concluded. But at that time, I was still fixed on the explanation that the anointed light of the world, as declared by Jesus, was solely for our sake. He said that only those that truly love him would be loved also by the Holy Father. The world would not see any manifestation. Only the faithful commandment keepers would experience the sight and spirit of truth, the Messiah. He seemed to have urgency in the foretelling of immediate events to occur. I have always been passionate about following the laws that Jesus taught, as well as his kindnesses. Somehow, I must grow to have more patience and mercy, yet not fall weak into ungodly persons that slip in amongst the strong believers, but are only dreamers that divide us back into our natural instincts. Woe be unto them, but I must persevere of myself in order also to save a few from the fire eternal. To God our glory, our Savior, majesty, power, and authority, through Jesus Christ forevermore. Therein lies salvation of the heart, and is not impossible. No one is hopeless or lost cause, not even the blind, double-tongued Gentiles in their most desperate situations. So is our hope and glory. Amen.
Every Wednesday evening, had time for prayer, and we placed our prayers on the community prayer cross that is near the road. These are the prayers that have been offered over the cross, onto the cross, for these last weeks, for these 40 days of Lent. So as we sing the last seven words, Father, into thy hands I commend to you my spirit, we lift up these prayers. We will sing the song three times, just as we've been doing on Wednesday evenings. It's the tune of Jesus Remembering.
Thank you.
the prayer of the day. Merciful God, your Son was lifted up on the cross to draw all people to himself. Grant that we who have been born out of the wounded side may at all times find mercy in him. Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Continue with our scripture readings this evening for Good Friday. Thank you, John, for being our scripture reader.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah, beginning with the 52nd chapter. See, my servant shall prosper. He shall be exalted and lifted up, and shall be very high. Just as there were many who were astonished at him, so marred was his appearance beyond human semblance, and his form beyond that of mortals. So he shall startle many nations. Kings shall shut their mouths because of him. For that which had not been told them, they shall see. And that which they had not heard, they shall contemplate. Who has believed what we have heard? And to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? For he grew up before him like a young plant, and like a root out of dry ground. He had no form or majesty that we should look at him, nothing in his appearance that we should desire him. He was despised and rejected by others, a man of suffering and acquainted with infirmity. And as one from whom others hide their faces, he was despised, and we held him of no account. Surely he has borne our infirmities and carried our diseases. Yet we accounted him stricken, struck down by God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions, crushed for our iniquities. Upon him was the punishment that made us whole, and by his bruises we are healed. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have all turned to our own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed, and he was afflicted, yet he did not open his mouth, like a lamb that is led to the slaughter, and like a sheep that before its shearers is silent, so he did not open his mouth. By a perversion of justice, he was taken away. Who could have imagined his future? For he was cut off from the land of the living, stricken for the transgression of my people. They made his grave with the wicked and his tomb with the rich, although he had done no violence and there was no deceit in his mouth. Yet it was the will of the Lord to crush him with pain. When you make his life an offering for sin, he shall see his offspring and shall prolong his days. The will of the Lord shall prosper. Out of his anguish he shall see light. He shall find satisfaction through his knowledge. The righteous one, my servant, shall make many righteous, for he who has promised is faithful. And let us consider how to provoke one another to love and good deeds, not neglecting to meet together, as is the habit of some, but encouraging one another, and all the more as you see the day approaching. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
We continue with the first verse. Song Go to Dark
Yesterday.
which he and his disciples entered. Now Judas, who betrayed him, also knew the place, because Jesus often met there with his disciples. So Judas brought a detachment of soldiers together with the police from the chief priests and the Pharisees, and they came there with lanterns and torches and weapons. Then Jesus, knowing all that was to happen to him, came forward and asked them, "Whom are you looking for?" They answered, "Jesus of Nazareth." Jesus replied, "I am he." Judas, who betrayed him, was standing with them. When Jesus said to them, "I am he," they stepped back and fell to the ground. Again, he asked them, "Whom are you looking for?" And they said, "Jesus of Nazareth." Jesus answered, "I told you that I am he, so if you are looking for me, let these men go." This was to fulfill the word that he had spoken, "I did not lose a single one of those whom you gave me." And Simon Peter, who had a sword, drew it, struck the high priest's slave, and cut off his right ear. The slave's name was Malchus. Jesus said to Peter, "Put your sword back into its sheath. Am I not to drink the cup that the Father